Hi, Ahmad here. Thank you for watching my video. Alright, what you can see behind me is my students who are learning how to pitch stands. These are primary 4 students. Inshallah, they'll be going for their camp in September later on. So they are learning how to pitch stands as early as April, a few months before their camp. Okay, so in my sharing today is that I would like to share that when we plan programs, we got to think or consider how the activity matches to the students. Okay, so learning point from me was that last year when we did the camp, the student pitched stand for the first time during the camp itself, and it took hours. Okay, so we realized that the activity is suitable for them, but they needed more time. Okay. So once again, when you plan program, you need to make sure that the activity it matches the student. It does not mean that if the students take a long time in the program, it doesn't mean that it is not suitable for them. Okay? It may be a point, maybe a case where you will have to structure the activity so that it gradually increases. They pick up skills along the way, or you give them longer preparation time to learn the skill. Okay? So in this case, we are taking a gradual approach where the students pick up some skills before they apply during the camp. The benefit of this approach is that the learning stays with the students over a longer period of time, meaning it is not only a one-time affair where they just do in a camp, and that is it. After the camp, they just go off and all the skills that they learn in the camp is all gone, or all the lessons that they learn in the camp is all gone. Okay, no, but in this case, in April this year, they learn, so they know how it feels like to pitch a tent, and then in September they will try again, and then maybe in their primary 5 or in the future years they try again. So by repeated attempt of the activity, then the lessons stay with them longer. Okay, the other benefit of this approach is that supposedly in this case we have done this approach, they have learned, and then during the P4 camp they pitch again. You as the other educator or the teacher, you have the option to analyze whether come next year whether the students will be ready for other challenges. So you can have the option to further increase the challenge, meaning right now they use a dome 10, so maybe in the future they may be tasked or challenged how to fix a basha, for example, so the challenge increases. Okay, yeah, so this is one good approach of being gradual in your activity planning. One last advantage of this approach is that you avoid the chance of what we call an over arousal of the activity. Meaning, so if you just do one time and during the camp and it may fail, so the students may be demoralized or may totally get switched off from the activity. So as other educators, we are bringing students out into the unfamiliar grounds. Because of the unfamiliar grounds, it's very important for you to try to capture their attention or their interest. Okay, once the student loses interest, once they find that the outdoors is too much for them, then they may not want to participate anymore. Okay, whereas actually we know that there's so much fun that they can get from the outdoor experience, but you need to be very careful and prudent with your planning. So make sure that the activity matches the participants, and if not, then look into how you can modify the approach so that the activity matches the profile of the participants. Okay, so other educators out there, good luck, have fun in preparing and planning for your programs. Okay, I wish you luck in the future or the many programs that you'll be planning for your students in this year and the future. Alright, take care and bye-bye.